Hey guys, I'm Robert. A few weeks ago, I made a video introducing Superwhisper and comparing it to other AI voice tools. Now, I want to go a little bit further with this. As I've mentioned before, we have many applications that can transcribe with very good quality, but Superwhisper, in my opinion, stands out because of its incredible versatility and features, not only as a dictation app where it can easily do what others already do, but also for so many different tasks. Let me show you something. Ask Perplexity. What is Whisper AI? So Perplexity opens. I can see my question there. I can see the response. With that, I will select this text. Can you please explain this to me in simple words? And while that's happening, I will close this website. I will open a note. And I will also close the recording window. And I will insert everything there. This is awesome. Can you please expand a little bit more? And in this case, the response that I get back comes back to me in the same kind of question answer as before. But let's say that I'm working on this and I feel like that recording window is a little bit too distracting for me. Then I can just simply toggle it off. Great. Can you please give me a list of related topics that can help me understand a little bit better? And as you can see, there's no more recording window here, and my result will go exactly in the same form as before. Question, answer. And I will ask something for this. Please help me draft one email with this information because I have to explain to this guy what this is all about. For this kind of task, I will normally use the bigger window. And as you saw, the result in this case didn't go to my front app because, of course, I don't want it in my notes app. I want it in my mail app. But let's say that before I want to paste it in my email, I want to do some edits on it. And now I can go to Alfred. Simon. Robert, I hope this is helpful. And of course, I don't need the subject here. And now I can go to my email and paste, and my edits are there. At its core, Superwhisper is a powerful dictation tool that combines transcription with AI processing. What makes it special? For me, there's two things that put this app above all the other similar ones out there. There's a one-time payment option for Superwhisper, and you get access to amazing models without the need of even using your own API keys. On the other hand, it comes packed with features like context awareness, customizable recording windows, local processing options, and different modes. While Superwhisper is very capable, many of the features are tucked away in different menus. As a power user, I found myself wanting quicker access to many options. That's why I created an Alfred workflow and some Keyboard Maestro macros to bring these powerful capabilities right to your fingertips. I'll show you how to set this up, but for the basic features and configuration of Superwhisper itself, check out Nail's channel. He's a developer and he has some great tutorials there. I've tried to make the setup of the workflow as simple as possible. In this latest workflow update, there's a new feature called the history filter. The speed of loading all the results depends on your number of items. You can select 0 to display all your history, but I only suggest you do that if you clean up your recordings folder once in a while, because I'm not sure how fast this would perform with thousands of files. I'll skip the favorite modes section for now and move down a bit. For Super Mode to work, you need to have it active in Superwhisper's configuration. This and the history panel use AppleScript to select items from Superwhisper's menu, since there's no direct way to do it. I wish there were deep links like for some of the other things, but there aren't any as far as I know. Now, about this copy selected text option. Superwhisper has a feature that allows a custom setting per mode to access contents of your clipboard. This is very useful when you want to perform an action on a specific text. Sometimes, though, I would miss copying the text in the time window, so I wrote a small Swift app that copies selected text when you use a workflow to record. This way, you don't have to worry about timing. Every time it copies, I also get an indicator on my menu bar with a Keyboard Maestro macro, which I'll cover a little bit later. This indicator is helpful because the small recording window doesn't show if it grabbed the clipboard, unlike the bigger window. Let's select OK for now. Now you got this installed. To access the main menu, you can use the SW keyword, but I prefer to use a shortcut. It's cleaner. If you have the default folder correctly set, all your modes should appear here. All you need to do is be on one, remember the name because you will need it, and press Command C. Then in the configuration, you can paste it as one of your favorite modes. As someone who mostly works with external triggers, I don't really use this, but I thought it would be useful for those who prefer the Alfred interface. Okay guys, from this point on, there's so many different directions that I could go. There's a lot of subtitles here that when you navigate through the different options, they tell you how to perform certain actions. I have to say that all of this, every single option here, with a modifier or without a modifier, can be triggered with a keyboard shortcut. And all the keyboard shortcuts have a note explaining what they do, so that you will just go in there and assign it to whatever is convenient for you. For the shortcuts for specific modes, you will need the same URL as we grabbed from the configuration. You can just click Save, then set your hotkey as usual. You also got some Alfred snippets here. If you set them up, you can easily insert your last dictated prompt, your last result, or everything together, including your system prompt. Some of the things that you can do are not super obvious. For example, you have the Alfred normal functions, and I'll show them to you in the main menu. Here, everything points to your last interaction with Superwhisper. Command Y opens Quick Look on the JSON file. Command L shows large text for your last result, and Command C we'll copy it. You also have Alfred actions. All of these perform different functions depending on which menu you are at. If I'm on the modes menu, everything will point to the specific mode. This is useful when you want to edit a mode quickly. For example, you can be on the mode, activate the Alfred file action, and directly change the system prompt. Or if you want to duplicate a mode, you can reveal the file and duplicate it. Then you change something in it. Just make sure that you also change the key for something different. For these changes that you make outside of the application, you will need to restart Superwhisper for the changes to be recognized. In the history filter, these keyboard shortcuts really shine. Here you can do something similar as what we saw in the main menu, like previewing either your dictation or your result with Command L, or you can quickly copy it with Command C. You can quick look the JSON file to double check information about the processing. And by the way, you can also do it with a cleaner Alfred text view using this modifier. This is useful in case you don't know why you didn't get back the results that you wanted. But unlike the main menu, here you can use all of this for any of your history items. A little extra that I added to the history filter is that you can also filter by date. If you start typing the date as it appears in the subtitle and then enter a space, you can start looking for titles that match specifically that day. That's as far as I'll go with explaining the workflow alone. You really have to go in there and try it. The Keyboard Maestro macro group adds even more functionality that I find very convenient. With this, I have my current Superwhisper mode on my menu bar, and I'm jumping between modes all day long, so I have many different shortcuts for my most used ones. And aside from my mode, I also have some visual indicators. I already told you about the one that tells me if the selected text was copied, but I also have, for example, this small triangle pointing up. If it's pointing up, it means that my recording window from Superwhisper is active. If it's pointing down, it means I turned it off. So for example, now I can dictate something. This is a very quick test, and the result will stay on my window. I also have something that I call action modes, so I will activate the paste result action mode. And with this, I will get my result on my front window. This is another very quick test, and the recording window will close. Aside from the paste result action mode, which by the way also has an icon there on my menu bar, I also have the paste chat action mode, another different icon, and now I will switch to a different mode. This is just a very quick test, and with this what happens is that the recording window will close and I will get my prompt together with the result. This allows me, for example, if I'm working on something that I really, really want to focus without any distraction, I can activate the paste result mode and I can toggle off the recording window. And as you can see, the triangle now is pointing down. I will just put the simple dictate mode. And now I can be talking to my computer and I do not have any recording window, and my text will go to my front app. Basically, with this, I have absolute control of whether I want recording window, I don't want recording window, I want to paste my result, I want my result on the recording window, or I want to paste the result together with my prompt, and I can always know what is active. This is also what is in charge of voice commands, such as web searches. This works best with modes that do not have AI enabled, and it supports out of the gate YouTube, Google, OpenAI, Claude, Perplexity, so you can do stuff like ask YouTube news on AI. If you know your way around Keyboard Maestro, I am sure that you can even add more stuff in there. The back and forth chat feature isn't officially part of Superwhisper, but its context awareness features that you set up optionally when creating modes work pretty well when combined with this context that you give it back, especially when using it inside the note. This is actually how I wrote this entire Alfred workflow, since my coding knowledge is very limited. All of this comes down to you trying it out and experimenting for yourself. The instructions for toggling the recording window, different paste action modes, and everything that I've shown you here and so much more is covered in the documentation. So if you want to dive deeper, make sure to check that out. I think that there are so many different use cases for everything that I've incorporated here, but it's really up to you and how creative you are. Some of these features, especially the experimental ones in the macros, are not official, so with an update from Superwhisper, they might stop working, and maybe I can fix them, maybe not. I would also love to hear how you are using Superwhisper. I'm very happy to read about it because it can give me inspiration and ideas on how to use it myself. I will be glad to make more content about how I use this app, but if you have any requests or suggestions, I'm also very happy to take that into consideration. Don't forget to subscribe to my newsletter to stay up to date on what I'm up to. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.